Hello. So today we will prove the Liouville's theorem. So Liouville's theorem is given by, so first I will write Liou. Liouville's theorem. So write down first statement. If a function f of z is analytic for all finite values of z, if a function f of z is analytic for all values of z and is bounded, then f of z is constant. So this is the statement of Liouville's theorem. If f of z is analytic at all the points of z and is bounded, then f of z is constant. So to prove this, I will take two points z1 and z2. So write down let proof z1 and z2 be any two points in a z plane. Let us take any two points z1 and z2 in a z plane and choose the counter c to be a large scale of r, and choose a counter c to be a large scale of R. Center at origin. Center at origin and containing the points z1 and z2. So let us say, if you want, you can draw this diagram. So this is a point z1. We have to choose a counter c. So let us say I will choose a counter c whose containing a large scale of r. Let us say this is r, and containing the two points, one more point that is equal to z2. So z1 and z2 are included in the counter c. So then now by using Cauchy's integral formula, so before that I will write therefore mod z1 is less than r, the magnitude of z1 is less than r, the magnitude of z2 is also less than r. And already given that if the function f of z is bounded, and f of z is bounded, what do you mean by bounded? F of z is bounded means that implies f of z is less than or equal to capital M for all z. F of z is less than or equal to capital M for all z. Now write down by Cauchy's integral formula. We have by Cauchy's integral formula. We have, what is Cauchy's integral formula? Cauchy's integral formula is given by f of a is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z divided by z minus a into dz. In place of a, we have z1. And for the next one, in place of a, we have z2. Means by using Cauchy's integral formula, we can write it as f of z1 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z divided by z minus a means z minus z1 into dz. Then say this is equation number 1. Similarly, f of z2 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z divided by z minus z2 into dz. Say that is equation number 2. So Cauchy's integral formula is given by f of a is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z divided by z minus a into dz. Only in place of a we have z1 and in place of a we have z2. So now equation 1 minus equation 2. If you write equation 1 minus equation 2, so that is equation 1 minus equation 2 gives. If you subtract left hand side, we can write it as f of z1 minus f of z2. And that is equal to right hand side 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z is common. That is 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z is common. So now we are left with 1 divided by z minus z1 minus 1 divided by z minus z2 into dz. So this is subtracting. Equation 1 minus equation 2 means f of z1 minus f of z2. This one, this whole term minus this whole term means you can take 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z, which is common. Then we are left with, here we are left with 1 divided by z minus z1 minus, here we are left with 1 divided by z minus z2. Dz is common, I have written it outside. And now this is equal to f of z1 minus f of z2 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z. If you simplify this, here LCM is, here LCM is z minus z1 into z minus z2. LCM is z minus z1 into z minus z2. By using cross product, z minus z2 minus into z is minus z, minus into minus z1 is plus z1, and this dz right as it is. So LCM is z minus z1 into z minus z2. By using cross product, 1 into z minus z2 is z minus z2, minus 1 into z minus z1, minus 1 into z is minus z, minus 1 into minus z1 is plus z1, where minus z and plus z get cancelled. So here we are left with, so f of z1 minus f of z2 is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z into z1 minus z2 you will get. So we are left with, this is plus z1 and then I have written this minus z2 divided by z minus z1 into z minus z2 into dz. And now I will take modulus on both these sides. So modulus of f of z1 minus f of z2 is equal to, I have written modulus of 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c f of z, z minus z2 divided by z minus z1 into z minus z2 into dz. Now you can write it as, this is also modulus. So we can write it as mod f of z1 minus mod f of z2. If you separate the mod, then you will get less than or equal to. I will write 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c outside. Then we can apply modulus for each term, mod f of z, mod z1 minus z2 divided by modulus of z minus z1 and modulus of z minus z2 into mod dz. And then we can write it as, substitute the values. So left hand side, this is less than r equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I integration of c. What is the value of mod f of z? Mod f of z is less than or equal to capital M. I have given mod f of z is bounded. So it is less than or equal to capital M. So in spite of mod f of z, I have written M. I will write mod z1 minus z2 as it is divided by this term. We can write it as mod z minus mod z1 and then mod z minus mod z2. So you know that mod z minus or mod x minus y is less than or equal to mod x minus mod y. So this is less than or equal to mod x minus mod y into mod dz. Now to simplify this, let, we know that I have taken a circle, so mod z is equal to r. So mod z is equal to r means, what is z value? Z value is equal to r into e raised to I theta. So we know that a complex number in polar form can be expressed as z is equal to r into e raised to I theta. So then dz is equal to, if you differentiate, what you will get? R is constant. Differentiation of e raised to I theta is e raised to I theta. Differentiation of I theta is I, and differentiation of theta is d theta. But the required term is mod dz. So mod dz is equal to, I will write directly, this is r, this is I as it is. Modulus of r is r. Modulus of I is I. Modulus of d theta is d theta. The remaining term is modulus of e raised to I theta. Modulus of e raised to I theta is nothing but modulus of cos theta plus I sin theta. And if x plus iy is a complex number, then its modulus of x plus iy is given by square root of x square plus y square. This is the modulus of complex number. So in place of x we have cos theta, and in place of y we have sin theta. So cos square theta plus sin square theta, square root of. But cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, modulus of e raised to I theta, it is given by, this is equal to 1. So here I will write, that is e raised to I theta is equal to 1. So this is the value for mod dz. Now, you have to substitute all these values in the above equation. So if you substitute in the above equation, I will write here, that is less than r equal to 1 divided by 2 pi I. M, I will write it outside. Integration of C means this is running from 0 to 2 pi. As we have taken a circle, therefore this C changes to, that is z is equal to r into e raised to I theta, mod z is equal to r means the limit changes from 0 to 2 pi. Then mod z minus z1 minus z2 divided by mod z value is r minus mod z1. And then one more value, r minus mod z2. And dz value, mod dz value is r I into d theta. So just you have to substitute, write down m divided by 2 pi I outside. Then integration of c means it is running from 0 to 2 pi, and that is mod z1 minus mod z2 divided by the value of mod z, that is equal to r. So r minus mod z1, r minus mod z2, mod dz value is equal to r I and d theta. So here I and I get cancels. So this is less than r equal to m divided by 2 pi. I'll write mod z1 minus z2 as it is, and then integration of 0 to 2 pi r into d theta divided by r minus mod z1 and r minus mod z2. So now we can also write it as, so this is less than r equal to m divided by 2 pi mod z1 minus z2. Then here 0 to 2 pi into r into d theta divided by, I will take r outside from this first bracket. So if you take R outside, here we are left with 1 minus mod Z1 divided by R. That is R into 1 is R minus R into mod Z1 divided by R. R, R get cancels. Again, you will get mod Z1. Similarly, again here, if you take R outside, here also we are left with 1 minus mod Z2 divided by R. And this one of the R get cancels. So then the remaining terms are, so mod F of Z1 minus mod F of Z2 is less than R equal to M divided by 2 pi mod Z1 minus Z2. Then the remaining terms are, so this R I will write here, divided by R into 1 minus mod Z1 into 1 minus mod Z2. Integration of 0 to 2 pi, the remaining term is d theta. So this is less than R equal to M divided by 2 pi mod Z1 minus Z2 divided by R into 1 divided by 1 minus mod Z1 into 1 minus mod Z2 into integration of d theta is theta, and this is running from 0 to 2 pi. Then if you simplify this, this is equal to M divided by 2 pi mod Z1 minus Z2 divided by R 1 divided by 1 minus mod Z1 into 1 minus mod Z2 into. So here you will get 2 pi minus lower limit is 0. So 2 pi minus 0. And 2 pi minus 0 is 2 pi. This 2 pi and this 2 pi get cancels. So this is less than R equal to M mod Z1 minus Z2 divided by R into 1 minus mod Z1 into 1 minus mod Z2. But we have given, already we have taken a counter C, a counter curve C, that is a circle containing a large scale of R. Large scale of R means the value of R goes on increasing. So as R tends to infinity, R tends to infinity. So this value, any number divided by infinity is equal to 0. So this is less than R equal to 0. So that is mod F of Z1 minus mod F of Z2. So this is, you will get, is equal to 0. And then, so if this is equal to 0, so mod F of Z1 is equal to mod F of Z2. And we know that Z1 and Z2 are arbitrary, therefore F of Z is constant. So write down here, Z1 and Z2 are arbitrary, therefore F of Z is constant, which is the required theorem. Thank you.